good? Good afternoon, everybody. I'd like to first thank you all for voting for me as Dave's new advocate. It means a lot that me, as a 22-year-old, can take care of a 64-year-old man.
I have a lot of plans for what I'd like to do for him. I also have some problems that I've encountered in just the 3 recent weeks that I've been his advocate. I'd first like to begin by giving a brief history of Dave. Dave is a 64-year-old male who grew up in state institutions. For those of you that don't know, state institutions were big, huge buildings filled with hundreds upon hundreds of people with developmental disabilities.
Now, David has a severe intellectual disability, meaning has the mentality of a 3 to 5-year-old. Being in a setting that's filthy, loud, noisy, violent, is not conducive to somebody's mentality growing in a positive manner. And he grew up like this for about 4 years. Approximately 20 years ago, Dave was moved into lifetime assistance into our current home in Sweden Hill. 20 years ago, his life changed. He's now a much more positive individual, much less violent. They don't have to use holds on him anymore. He doesn't bite himself as much as he used to. However, in the last couple weeks, he's been diagnosed with dementia. Now, dementia, as many of you know, is a disease that eats away at the brain and makes it so you lose your memory. On top of losing your memory, you become more and more frustrated from not knowing what to remember, what to do. You can't remember your life. It's just an all-around frustrating event. Now, to combat this problem, I thought of two various solutions that I'd like to propose to you today to hopefully be approved for the budget. The first one, I'd like to convert his room into a sensory room. I've looked up an Epson brand DVD player projector that's high definition, projects its own sound. On top of that, I found a pack of sensory DVDs. These DVDs are various weather conditions, such as like the rain, waves, I guess this isn't a weather condition, but the city noise, air conditioner. These are all made to help him calm down and relax. It would project onto his blank white wall. He then had that environment to look at and have the noises to calm down him. This has been projected to be around $1,000 for this small part of his budget. I set that aside as the first part of the budget. The second part of the budget I'd like to propose is I'd like to buy him a home theater system. Now, a home theater system was composed of a JBL surround sound, which was priced around $350. I'd also like to get him a 55-inch curved 3D TV built by LG. This will be approximately $1,800. I'd also like to buy him a Roku First TV. For those of you that don't know, Roku's a little box. Plug that bad boy up there. He then gets Netflix, Hulu, sports packages, and various movies that you can buy out from there. On top of that, I'd also like to buy him a brand new Sleep Number bed. Now, for those of you that know, Dave watches TV, which is his favorite pastime. He watches the sports and the movies. However, he does it from his bed. He does it in his birthday suit. It's a good time. Dave also doesn't like pillows. This means he crawls into bed, buck naked, crawls in there, pulls up the blankets, then throws a pillow across the room. He then watches TV, leaning his head up, arched up there, just watching whatever's on. And he cannot be comfortable, especially not for years upon years upon years. On top of that, his mattress is falling apart from his occasional incontinence. Nobody wants to live like that on a bed that's falling apart, slash blatantly smells like pee. That's why I propose we get him a brand new Sleep Number bed. I'd like to get him the M7 model. It's approximately $49.99, so $5,000. I think I had the right number, nines. Without delivery. On top of that, it'd be another $200 for a waterproof covering. And I'd like to get him some silk sheets, because who doesn't like silk? So with this new bed, it would be a memory foam bed, as well as be adjustable, therefore allowing him to lean on his head and not have to arch his neck up and potentially cause more and more problems that we don't need in his life. So some reasons why you might want to care about this. With the beginning stages of dementia, we've noticed in Dave that in the morning when he has to do his goals, for those of you that don't know, goals in our company is how we bill for our patients. We have different things we try to aim for them to do. So for instance, with Dave, one of his things was watering plants, as well as taking out the trash in the morning. Now we've noticed in Dave that when we ask for these tasks to be done, he'll start to do the task, and then he'll forget what he was doing, get upset, and begin his self-injurious behaviors. When Dave gets upset, gets confused, or gets stressed, he starts biting on his finger and biting on his arm. Today he did it to the point of bleeding. This is actually true. Today he did it on his arm to the point of bleeding. Now, I don't want this to continue for the next few years. As some of you know, stress can increase the symptoms of dementia. Now, we had a resident by the name of Mark. Approximately 6 months ago, he was diagnosed with dementia. His advocate never did anything for him, never changed his environment, left him in the stressful group home that he was in, because of which, in less than 2 months, his symptoms progressed
to such a state where he had to be hospitalized. He was not hospitalized until he died. I refuse to let this happen to the man that I love, by the name of Dave Costello.